Welcome to Ready Read Along. Today I wanted something a little different, so we're going to be doing some r/niceguys, where guys who are anything but nice try to convince you that they are the nice guy. Let's go! This is already starting out great. I work at Hooters, yet I still can't lose my virginity. This is going to be extremely dumb. I got a job at Hooters as a dishwasher. Have been working there for around 4 months. I've been working there around 4 months now, and I still haven't come close to sleep with any of the girls there. This is just absurd. Okay. Been working there for around 4 months now, and I still haven't come close to sleeping with any of the girls there. I haven't even got to be any of their friends. I mean, first off, let me stop there. Like, those are two completely different things. Like, you should either try to pick out these women that you work with as friends and not pursue them romantically, or you need to let your feelings or your intentions be known up front, instead of making the girl think that you're trying to become her friend, you're really just trying to wear her down and get her to go with you. Alright, they just treat me nice, and me and them have small conversations during the lunch, but that's it. I thought I would have been able to sleep with at least one of the girls there. Because of the reputation Hooters have and the outfits that they wear. And I see some of the male cooks there flirting with the girls and stuff. And I can sense hooking up happening in the workplace, but I can't get anything. His spider senses are tingling. He's like, someone's having sex. I can feel it. The hairs on the back of my neck, they're just standing all the way up, so I know someone's getting down. Like, there's so much wrong with this. Like I said earlier, you need to either try to be these people's, women's friend, or you need to let your intentions be known. You should not, like, this is like, there's also the problem of him thinking just because these women are dressed like this and work at Hooters, thinking that they're just going to sleep with him. That's dumb and kind of gross there. And then just even if it wasn't at Hooters, just because he saw like a girl in really short, like shorts and stuff, doesn't mean that she's just going to sleep with him. So that's the first problem we have there. Then also, the fact that he is planning on basically wearing them down or becoming their friends or being really nice to them, acting like their friends until they have a chance to try to make a move on them. And then the friend, the female, the woman who's going to be like, you're my friend. I don't see you like that. And he's going to explode about and call her names and stuff about her leading them on, and the whole time it's because he was trying to wear her down while she was just trying to have a friend. Those are two completely different things. So yeah, he needs to fix that. We got another quick story from r/niceguys. Girls don't want nice guys. They are attracted to can't say that on YouTube or TikTok. They're attracted to a-holes, so nice guys get dumped, turn into a-holes to be more attractive. Scientifically proven? No, it's not. No, it's not. And then they proceed to do a-hole things, and girls get hurt and turn into thoughts. It's a vicious cycle till women hit about 35, at which point they finally realize that they should have just stuck to the nice guy. But at that point, nice guys don't want them. And then you die alone, smiley face. God, this is so toxic. Like, I love this forum because the stuff on here is so stupid, but it's also infuriating because the stuff on here is so stupid and toxic. And this is like the stuff that makes incels and people who just hate women for no real reason just because they got rejected. And this guy's calling himself a nice guy, but then proceeds to say all this stuff, proving that he's not a nice guy. And then he seems so excited that the women die alone. And then, in fact, he says scientifically proven that that nice guys become a-holes because it's more attractive to females. Okay, not all women are alike. There are some women out there who do tend to go towards a-holes or people who you are left wondering, why are you still with this person? But that is not every woman. You can't put them all in this little bubble like that. And that's just sad that this person thinks that scientifically, like, he did the research, he put in the hours, he did the Googling, he read the peer reviews, all that, that it's scientifically proven that nice guys must become a-holes to become more attracted to females. And so that's what he thinks you should do, and that's his advice. And then I guess his other advice is to women to, like, you better come to your senses fast, because once you hit 35, you're pretty much just out of the game and no one wants you. You're used goods at that point. Yeah. So this is a short one, but it really seems more like it should be in a stalking subreddit instead of a r/niceguys. This woman received this after going on one date with this person. Good morning. All I did was search your first name and phone number. Laura Blank. That's cute. Maybe give the men you respect a secondary number. Not everyone you meet will be a gem of a person like yours truly. And you have a family to protect. Good gosh, that... Wow, that one sentence there. Is this a threat? God bless and best of luck in your search. Girl, he gonna kill you. I kindly ask that you stop contacting me. Thank you. Oh my god! Don't do this, people! Don't do this, whether you're a guy, girl, non-binary, whoever, don't do this! Wow! Like, I'm sure everyone has Googled somebody at one point or another. Not necessarily somebody that they're involved with, but just like random person or whatever, Google search or something, I don't know. But don't do this. This is horrible. Like, even if you're going to Google somebody, don't send this, which seems like a threatening text. Like, he might as well have sent her a letter that was written in cut out letters from magazines and newspapers. That would be less creepy than this. What gets me is that sentence there. And you have a family to protect. This is all bad as it is, but then even if you took that out, it's still bad. But to have that in there escalates it to almost like you just got a stalker. I'm sorry. Time to move and pay to get, like, all your information cleared from the internet in general, because this person, somebody do a welfare check to make sure this guy hasn't tried to, kidnap her or something. This is horrible. I don't know if I should put a trigger warning in front of this or not. Usually these nice guy posts are kind of funny. This one just makes me feel icky and dirty. Like, I need to go take a shower. I think I might do that now. Let me know in the comments if you received any interactions with nice guys or have any, stories yourself. And whether you're watching on TikTok or YouTube, I really do appreciate you hitting that like and that follow button. and come back and, listen to some other stories. I'm about to go take a shower and cry.